Most WordPress users are actually scared of updating their WordPress theme all by themselves. They normally employ the services of freelancers from marketplaces such as Fiverr, Upwork, and lots of them you find out there. So if you're one of them, after watching this video, you should be able to carry out an update on your WordPress theme all by yourself, and you won't lose any form of customization, because that's a fear most newbies of WordPress normally have, and that's the reason why they see it, or they see the need of employing the services of freelancers. So like, if you'll agree with me, most free themes you can easily update it from your WordPress site by just heading to update and it will be updated. But in some cases whereby you purchase paid theme, you discover that you need to carry out updates all by yourself. But some paid theme sites also give plugins by which you can automatically update your WordPress themes, but I don't like using that, because in some cases, once there's bug in the theme, then the update was automatic, then you see you start regretting. So that's why I normally prefer updating manually by myself. So that's what I'll be showing you in this video. I'll be showing you how to update WordPress theme manually without losing any form of customization, in the sense that the way your WordPress site appears before the update is the same way it should appear. And this normally works also if you want to like update or switch a theme from one you're using to another one. So in this case, we shall be updating this very theme. This is my Theme Forest dashboard, or my Envato Market dashboard, and I received a notification via email that this there's an update in this very theme, which is new Sophie, that I installed on this very WordPress site of mine. So I'd like to update this site, but before I proceed, let me first of all show you the view of this website, so take notes and we'll see if it will appear the same way once I've carried out the theme update. So as you can see, this is the site, and look, it's actually running, AdSense is actually running on the site, which means I wouldn't have to like remove the AdSense code and start placing it one by one once I've done the update. So let me show you how you can do that manually without receiving, or without experiencing any form of changes in your new site. So now, first of all, let me go to my Envato theme. All I have to do, I need to switch to the recent update just like I did here, and I want to download this update. Actually choose all file. I've downloaded the file earlier on to save stress, and this is the file right here on my desktop. So all I have to do, I actually downloaded all theme files. So all I have to do is to extract this, extract it here, and the extraction is complete. So now let me head, I'll have to fish out the theme itself. I open this folder, and this is the theme I'm actually looking for. This is the default theme, new Sophie. The online documentation, the licensing, I've gone through all that before, so there's no need for that. So all I have to do, let me copy this very theme file itself and place it on my desktop. So I believe, yes, this is a file, it's now here. So now let's now move to the WordPress site that actually want to carry out this theme update. Like I told you, this is the same thing, new Sophie is running on the site already, and this page will be here, so that once I carry out the update, will compare if all the customization are still existing on that same page. Remember, like I told you, this is my Envato, this is a Theme Forest theme, actually purchased on Theme Forest, but it also work with themes purchased on my theme shop and the like. So these steps are similar. Now let's go to the step. If you're liking this video already and you want to be part of this channel whereby I see more tutorial videos coming from you just like this, you can simply hit the subscribe button and also turn on the bell notification so that I get notified whenever I put up another similar tutorial videos just like this. Blogging for Tech channel actually dish out tutorials, a tutorial based channel, so I teach you how to carry lots of function all by yourself, so you can be part of the channel once you've done that. So now let's go to the appearance and theme. Now take note of the steps and do exactly what I do once over you want to carry out a theme update manually. So as you can see, new Sophie is the name of the theme. Let's see new Sophie, and let's go back and compare. As you can see right here, New Sophie is the theme itself. So let me scroll down. That's the theme I downloaded. So now let's go back. And now the first step you have to do once you've come to this portion is to, first of all, in all themes, don't ever delete one of the default WordPress theme that comes with your theme. As you can see, this is 2023 theme. Always leave one theme behind and your original theme you purchased. So now, first of all, we'll first of all downgrade to this very theme. All I have to do is, no need to preview, just activate this very theme. It's activating. Scroll down. Automatically, you see that I've switched this WordPress site to this variety, which is the default WordPress theme that comes with it, 2023. Now, all you have to do now, let's see, first of all, let's go to this theme and let's see the version is running already. As you can see, this is version 1.2.1. Take note, it's version 1.2.1. So now we have to delete this theme. That's the new Sophie, the version that is already running on this website. You have to delete it. And as you can see, I don't want to switch to the view. Don't switch to the view. Don't just go there. Now let's add this very latest version of new Sophie that I've downloaded to my desktop. So now what I have to do is to click on add new. Then upload theme. Then let's choose file. Then from my desktop, this is the new Sophie. So after this, to select it, then open. Then let's scroll down a little bit and click on install. So as you can see, the installation process has started. And once it has completed, all I have to do is to activate the theme. Let's see. Okay. The process is complete. Just as you can see, it says theme installed successfully. So now all I have to do is to activate the theme. So it has been activated. Now let's see the version theme details. Remember, the version that we deleted earlier was version 1.2.1. As you can see, the latest version is version 1.2.2, which means it's not running on the current version. So now next thing I'll have to do is to visit this website and see this site is actually run, and see if the customization, if there's any difference from the new customization and the earlier one. As you can see, everything remains the same because I did this just the way I arranged it. So this is a new one, that's this is the WordPress site running on the updated version, and this is the old one I opened earlier running on the older version. As you can see, my AdSense codes are still existing on this new site, and which means all customization are still intact. The footer logo, the footer page link, and everything is still intact, just the way it was in this previous version. So you can see how easy it is for you to actually update your WordPress theme manually without losing any form of customization. So if you find this video interesting enough, you can simply give it a thumbs up, and if you are concerned or maybe you want clarification in any area, you can go to the comment section below, ask your question, and I will attend to them speedily. So with that, we'll come to the end of this video. And before we leave, like I said from the start, Shibuzo Agua is my name, and Blogging for Tech is the name of this channel. So I believe you're part of the channel already, and you're welcome. So just sit back, relax, and anticipate for my next video. So bye bye for now.